Today I will be talking about mucormycosis, which is colloquially known as black fungus. Nowadays, people know this fungus as black fungus. It is an infection or a disease which is caused by the mucormycetes group of fungi. They are abundantly found in soil, plants, manure, and decaying fruits and vegetables. Normally, they are like decomposers. They feast on the dead organism and take up the nutrients and then provide it to the soil. They play a vital role in the circulation of nutrients in the environment. So we all know this disease is pretty rare and it is not a new disease, but it can be debilitating or fatal if not treated quickly. It is not that common among us as our immune system is strong enough to fight this fungus. But if one takes this COVID-19 situation after getting infected with coronavirus, patients' immune system gets hampered. It gets so weak that it is not capable to fight black fungus. Doctors believe mucormycosis, which has an overall mortality rate of 50%, may be being triggered by steroids, which is a life treatment for severe and critically ill COVID-19 patients. But it also reduces, steroids also reduces immunity and push up blood sugar levels in both diabetic and non-diabetic patients. Normally, already, diabetes lowers the body immune defenses and steroids, which help fight COVID-19, act like fuel to the fire. Now, the big question is, how do we come in contact with it? So, humans can get infection by inhaling the fungal pores floating around the skin and in the dust. It can also enter our body through a cut, scrape, burn, or other types of skin trauma. People engaged in farming or gardening who come in frequent contact with soil are at higher risk of contracting it. Also, the people experience fungi most often in their kitchen when fruits rot or their bread turns moldy. There also, there's a high chance of contracting it. So this disease progresses rapidly. Though it does not spread from person to person, it is a non-communicable disease. It can definitely progress from one body part to another. It attacks blood vessels and live tissues. As it kills them, it turns them all black. In just 3 days, it can spread to the eyes, nose, or jawbone. And if it is not treated early, the only way to stop the spread is to remove the infected eye, infected tissue, or the jawbone surgically. So some of the symptoms are stuffy and bleeding nose, swelling and pain in the eye, drooping of eyelids, and blurred vision, and finally loss of vision. There could be black patches of skin around the nose also. And about the treatment of it. So the two drugs which are most effective at treating mucormycosis are amphotericin B and posaconazole. They are effective provided the infection is found early. So this antifungal intravenous injection, it costs 3,500 rupees a dose and has to be administered every day for up to 8 weeks. Then only it will be effective against the disease. So here on the screen we can see the non-surgery, the patients which did not had surgery, their surviving chance was very less. The people who did not survive were more. And the people who had surgery, their surviving chance were more than the people who did not survive. Also, one has to take care of our diet and try to remain fit and try to boost our immune system after COVID recovery. If we do not take care, then getting exposed to this fungus will be fatal. So here are a few simple steps we can follow to lower our risk of contracting mucormycosis. Is to make sure that COVID-19 patient, both in treatment and after recovery, were being administered the right dose, and duration of steroids. Also, the doctor should take care of this sugar levels after the patient are discharged. And the recovering patient, they should be advised to remain indoors until they regain their natural strength and immunity. And the patient which are engaged in farming and gardening, they should be advised to lay off from work until the storm has settled. So on the screen, you have some do's and don'ts, which you can read. So the main threat to life, the people who are prone to this infection are like the diabetic or severely immunocompromised patients, such as those with cancer or HIV. So in the last, I would like to tell the people who are getting recovered from COVID-19, please don't take it lightly, as there is another infection waiting for you. Please try to boost your immune system. Remain healthy. Take care. Have a healthy life. Thank you.